Hello and welcome to Alphons Zeilais. My name is Johanna Nagelsbach. I am the grandniece of the painter Alphons Zeilais. In 1910, Alphons Zeilais continued to strive for artistic learning. He attended a composing class. In this video, you can find out with whom.
Composition refers to the conscious, well-considered or intuitive selection and arrangement of pictorial means in the work of art. This includes, for example, the format lines, for example, diagonal lines, surfaces such as triangular composition, colors, contrasts, light and shadow, etc. Alphons Zeilais attended this composition class with Professor Karl Johann Becker-Gundahl. Alphons Zeilais writes, "Differences in the awarding of the commission to paint the apsia of the Munich Chapel of the Missionary Benedictines study home brought me into contact with Professor Becker-Gundahl. At the time, he had received an appointment at the academy to head a drawing and composition class. I became his first student composer for 5 semesters. Professor Becker-Gundahl came from Ballweiler in what was then the Bavarian Palatinate, now Saarland. If you are wondering why Professor Becker-Gundahl had a double name, he didn't adopt a double name as a result of marriage. That didn't exist back then. Around 1890, he also took the name Gundahl after his grandmother. Becker-Gundahl was one of the founders of the Munich Secession. He drew for the Fliegende Blätter and other magazines and from 1900 onwards received major commissions for frescoes and mosaics, such as in St. Maximilian in Munich's Isarvorstadt district, but also decorated the walls of secular buildings such as the Hotel zur Krone in Hachenburg. With his monumental style, he became the most successful independent Munich muralist of his time. Becker-Gundahl had a much stronger influence on Alphons Zeilais than the traditional painter Professor Karl von Mahr. In 1910, Alphons Zeilais created some remarkable oil paintings in which he visibly used different compositions. How would Meyer Graefe, whom we met in the video on the Centennial Exhibition of German Art, have described these paintings? Possibly similar to these descriptions. Forest interior, brown and green tones with beige background. Tree study, impasto application of dark black green oil paint and ochre tones in the foreground, merging into blue and pink towards the top. Park study in the English garden, dark contours and shadows against a brown and ochre surface at the bottom, whitish blue at the top. Early spring in the English garden. Dark green areas against a beige and yellowish background with blue spots partly applied in impasto. The video Alphons Zeilais and the Centennial Exhibition dealt with such a way of describing pictures. In these pictures, Alphons Zeilais is clearly experimenting with lines, contrasts, color distribution, dark at the bottom, light at the bottom, dark at the top, and so on. Alphons Zeilais develops, tries things out, and implements what he has learned.
Thank you for accompanying Alphons Zeilais in his early days as a student composer with Professor Becker-Gundahl. In the next video, we will meet Professor Karl von Mahr again, not as professor of Alphons Zeilais, but as an opponent of an old acquaintance. I look forward to seeing you again.